In this video, I will talk about how to find the basic feasible solutions to a linear programming problem in the standard form. The basic feasible solutions will be used later in the simplex method. Let's consider a linear programming problem in the standard form that contains n variables and m constraints. We assume n is greater than or equal to m. We can get a basic solution by setting n minus m variables equal to 0 and solving for the remaining m variables. The n minus m variables are called non-basic variables, or NBVs, and the remaining m variables are called basic variables, or BVs. The total number of basic solutions is equal to n choose m, or n choose n minus m, which is n factorial divided by m factorial times n minus m factorial. Not every basic solution is feasible. If all the variables are non-negative in a basic solution, then this basic solution is a basic feasible solution, or BFS. Let's check the concept of basic feasible solution using this linear programming problem with two variables. First of all, we need to introduce two select variables to make the constraints equations. Now the problem is in the standard form. We have n is equal to 4 variables, x1, x2, S1 and S2. M is equal to 2 equations. So we need to pick n minus m is equal to 2 non-basic variables and set them to 0 and solve for the remaining m is equal to 2 basic variables. N choose m or n choose n minus m is equal to 6. We can use 6 possible combinations to choose non-basic variables. They are listed in the left column. For the first combination, x1 is equal to x2 is equal to 0. We plug these values into the equations. This part will be 0. So S1 is equal to 9 and S2 is equal to 9. Because both basic variables are non-negative, so this is the basic feasible solution. You can do this for all other combinations. The second and the fifth are not basic feasible solutions because they have negative values. Now we introduce some theorems. First, the feasible region of any linear programming problem is a convex set. This is because every linear constraint will split the space in half. Each half space is a convex set. The intersection of convex sets is a convex set. Therefore, the feasible region is a convex set. Second, the basic feasible solution of a linear programming problem are actually the extreme points of the feasible region. Third, any linear programming problem has a finite number of basic feasible solutions. This is because they have a finite number of extreme points in the feasible region. And last, if a linear programming problem has an optimal solution, there must be an extreme point that is optimal. To illustrate these theorems, let's recheck this example. This is a regional problem. The feasible region is a shaded area. It is indeed a convex set. This table shows the basic feasible solutions. The first basic feasible solution, 0, 0, corresponds to this extreme point. The second basic feasible solution, 0, 4.5, corresponds to this extreme point. The third basic feasible solution, 4.5, 0, corresponds to this extreme point. And the last basic feasible solution, 3, 3, corresponds to this extreme point. We only have 4 basic feasible solutions, which is a finite number. The other two are not basic feasible solutions. The last theorem says if a linear programming problem has an optimal solution, there must be an extreme point that is optimal. You can use a graphic method to solve the linear programming problem. You will find this point A is the optimal solution. Z is equal to 15. Point A is an extreme point. Now compare the last theorem with this statement. The theorem says if a linear programming problem has an optimal solution, there must be an extreme point that is optimal. This statement says if a linear programming problem has an optimal solution, then this optimal solution must be an extreme point. True or false? The answer is false. I'll just show you a counterexample. This is the original problem, and the optimal solution is a single point. If we modify the objective function and change this coefficient from 3 to 4, then we will have infinite number of optimal solutions between 0.33 and 4.50. Now let's check this statement again. This linear programming problem does have an optimal solution, actually more than one optimal solution. Let's just consider the middle point, which is an optimal solution. However, it is not an extreme point. This is a counterexample, so the statement is false. Now I'll introduce another concept. For any linear programming problem with m constraints, two basic feasible solutions are adjacent if they have m-1 basic variables in common. Let's check this basic feasible solution table and the graphic meaning. The standard form of the original problem has two equality constraints. So m is equal to 2 and m-1 is equal to 1. If two basic feasible solutions share one basic variable, they are adjacent. The first basic feasible solution has two basic variables, s1 and s2. Let's find basic feasible solutions that are adjacent to this one. s2 is a basic variable in this basic solution. However, it's not a basic feasible solution, so it's not adjacent to the first basic feasible solution. s1 is a basic variable in this basic feasible solution, so it is adjacent to the first basic feasible solution. s2 is a basic variable in this basic feasible solution, so it is also adjacent to the first basic feasible solution. s1 is a basic variable in this basic solution, however, it's not a basic feasible solution, so it's not adjacent to the first basic feasible solution. There is no s1 or s2 in the last basic feasible solution, so it's not adjacent to the first one. The graphical meaning is easier to understand. An adjacent point to this extreme point is the direct neighbor. Now let's check the concepts introduced in this video using an example with three variables. x1 is greater than or equal to 0 means we are considering the space from this plane, x2, x3, and going to the right. x2 is greater than or equal to 0 means we are considering the space from this plane, x1, x3, and going inside. x3 is greater than or equal to 0 means we are considering the space from this plane, x1, x2, and going up. x3 is less than or equal to 5 means we are considering the space from this plane and going down. x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 4 means we are considering the space from this plane and going towards the origin, 0. Therefore, the intersection is the feasible region bounded by the triangular prism in three-dimensional space. Let's change it to the standard form by adding two slack variables, s1 and s2. Now we have n is equal to 5 variables. M is equal to 2 equations. We set n minus m is equal to 3 non-basic variables to 0, and so for the m is equal to 2 remaining basic variables. There are a total of 10 possible combinations. They are listed in this table. Plug the non-basic variables into the two equations, and so for the basic variables. You will find that there are 6 basic feasible solutions, and others are infeasible. Now let's check the first basic feasible solution and try to identify its adjacent basic feasible solutions. We have a total of m is equal to 2 equations, so we only need to find m-1 is equal to 1 common basic variable. The basic variables are s1 and s2. This basic feasible solution has s1, this one has s2, and this one has s2, so they are all adjacent basic feasible solutions. These two don't have S1 or S2, so they are not adjacent. It is easier to find the adjacent basic feasible solutions to this point graphically. They're just its direct neighbors. Okay, that is how to find a basic feasible solution to a linear programming problem in the standard form. If a linear programming problem has more than 3 variables, we cannot represent it graphically. However, all the introduced theorems are still true for the problem. Thanks for watching.